Hello friends, in our previous lecture we have started with our second chapter of account, that is depreciation accounts. We have discussed the important points, the formulas and the journal entries for fixed installment or a straight line method. Today we are going to start with sum. Now friends, in exam this sum will be asked for 6 marks. In 6 marks you have to write the journal entry, you have to prepare a machinery account and a depreciation account, or else if I ask differently, then effect in final accounts. Now friends, one more thing which I need to say is that in all the sums, all the things will not be asked. Suppose if I am asking journal entries and only machinery account, then that can be asked only for 6 marks, because you need to do some necessary calculations for that also. And if else I am asking journal entries, if I am not asking journal entries, directly I am asking machinery account, then directly you prepare machinery account and a depreciation account. And effect in final accounts also can be asked. Now for that, we are having first sum, which includes all the necessary things. Means here we want to do calculation will be done in each and every sum. Okay, first thing is that calculation will be done in each and every sum. Now, calculation will be done, then formulas will be kept for depreciation, annual depreciation will be found, then journal entries will be passed, machinery account will be prepared, then depreciation account will be prepared, effect in final accounts also will be shown. So this is totally sum for your base, but in exam all the things will not there. Suppose if I am deleting effect in final accounts, then you prepare only calculation, then journal entries, then machinery account and depreciation account. That thing can be asked in 6 marks. And one thing I may warn to each and everyone, that normally this chapter every year students are ignoring. They are thinking that this is something very difficult. But friends, this is the most important topic. Okay, I know it is difficult and accountancy whole thing is difficult if you are not practicing well. And I know these days 90% students are ignoring my lecture, not completing their works. Friends, this is up to you. I am not discussing what will happen in future to you. I will not discuss today now anything. I will only discuss about the sum. And friends, we are having again two types of sums, where there is only one machinery, where there is two machinery. Now for instance, for starting sums we are having only one machinery. So today we are doing the first sum. So you look properly, try to understand. If you are not understanding, watch it 2 or 3 times. Still you are having doubt, make a note of it. Make a note of it. In any of the chapter you have any of the doubt, make a note, and then when the school reopens you can ask me the doubt. Okay, now we are starting. Come to page number 66. Now in that you can see in question number 5, answer the following questions as directed. From 1 to 11 questions are there. In that 10th and 11th questions are ignored in at this time in this course. Okay, so we are having 9 sums. Daily we can complete only 1 sum because sums are big. So this chapter will take now 9 more days to complete. First sum I am reading. Suresh Limited has purchased a machine for 63,600 on 1/4/2012. Installation expense of machine was incurred 1,000. Scrap value is estimated 14,600 after its estimated life of 8 years. Determine the annual amount of depreciation and annual rate of depreciation. Yesterday we have written 2 formulas for finding depreciation, where scrap value and estimated life is given and where the percentage is given. In this sum percentage is not given. We have given a scrap value and we have given a time period. So we have to calculate on that basis. Also we have to calculate rate of depreciation. That also formula I have given yesterday. Now what is to be done? An accounting year of company ends on 31st March. Always you understand this thing. In accountancy, the year will start from 1st April and it will end on 31st March of next year. So suppose here first date is written 1/4/2012. So that year will end on 31/3/13. Again next year will start on 1/4/13. It will end on 31/3/14. Again next year will start on 1/4/13 and it will end on 31/3/15. Now what you have to do in this question, as I said in this question, all the things are asked for our base. But in exam, if I am asking the same sum, I will not ask all the things. I will ask only remaining things.
Okay, write journal entries for first 3 years. You have to write the journal entries. You have to prepare a machine account and a depreciation account. Show accounting effects in annual accounts for the first year. Okay, so all the things you have to do, and company charges depreciation as per straight line method. In that also, if I say from sum number 1 to 11, 10 and 11 are ignored. And from sum number 1 to 8, sorry, sum number, I think it is, yes, from sum number 1 to 6, from sum number 1 to 6, we are having straight line method or fixed installment method, and after that 7th, 8th and 9th sum, 7th, 8th and 9th sum are according to the next method, that is reducing balance method. Any of the sum can be asked in exam any of the time. Okay, so now we are starting. So first we have to start the sum with a calculation. How to do the calculation? Look here. Okay, so this is question number 1. How to do the calculation? First thing is to write the accounting years. Here the calculation is done for 3 years. So the first thing is to write the accounting years. 3 of the accounting years you have to write. Which are they? First year, second year, third year. Now, your machinery is purchased on 1/12 and it is the starting of first year itself. 2. This year will end on 31st March next year. This is first April and this is 31st March. In 2012 it is starting, in 2013 it is completing. Then again, the next year will start from the next day. 1/4/13, it will end on 31/3/14. Again, 1/4/14 to 31/3/15. So these are the 3 years. This sum is little bit easy because in this sum we are only purchasing the machine, we are not selling the machine. Okay, so we are purchasing the machine on this day and till 31/3/15 we are not selling that machine. Okay, so nothing is putting. If machinery is purchased and sold in between, then we will write the important dates also here. But here only the thing is that machinery purchased on 1/4, no other important date to be considered in the sum. Okay, so the first and foremost thing is to write the accounting years. Next thing is to calculate the depreciation. Now see friends, how to do the depreciation, that is also important. Here the rate is not given, means the percentage is not given. Here scrap value and estimated life is given. So for that, now we will calculate annual depreciation. Annual depreciation. Now annual depreciation is as per the information given. Purchase price is 63,600. Expenses are 1,000. Scrap value is 14,600. And estimated life is of 8 years. First we need the cost price. Therefore cost price is equals to purchase price plus expense. 63,600 plus 1,000, which will come to 64,600. Now depreciation D is equals to cost price C minus scrap S divided by estimated life N. So 64,600 minus 14,600 divided by 8 years. So So our B will be $64,600 - $14,600 / 8 years. So depreciation will be $6,250 annual depreciation. So per year our depreciation will be $6,250. Now also we have to find rate of depreciation. So rate of depreciation is equals to annual depreciation D, as I have given the formula yesterday, cost price C into 100.
Okay.
So 6250 divided by cost price is 64600 into 100. 6250 divided by 64600 into 100.
Divided by 64600 into 100, 9.64%. Okay, depreciation is 9.67, right? Two digits after the decimals. Okay, yes, this is also over. So now calculation is over. Now the thing is to write the journal entries. Okay. So journal entries in books of Suresh Limited. In books of Suresh Limited. Okay. Date, particulars, LF, debit, credit. Same journal entries are going to be passed. Okay, so here give the heading first year. Now as you know, in the first year we are purchasing the machine, then calculating depreciation and closing the depreciation. So on 1/4/12 machinery is purchased, machinery is coming in, amount is paid to bank for purchase price and through cash for expense. So the journal entry would be machinery account debit to bank account to cash account. Always this entry is to be passed. Now bank account we have purchase price 63600, cash account we have expenses of 1000, so total will be 64600, the cost price and the machinery. And in narration B, machinery purchased. Now the next entry is to calculate the depreciation at the end of the year. End of the first year is 31,330. What was the entry for calculating depreciation? Depreciation account debit to machinery account. And what is the amount of depreciation? 6250. Being depreciation charged. Write a very short narration. Being depreciation charged. Okay. Then to close this depreciation account, what will be the entry? Profit and loss account debit to machinery account. Same amount, 6250.
being depreciation closed. So these are the entries for first year. Now journal entries for second year, for that make a line. Don't take the total, make a line and then write second year. Now from second year, always these two entries are written, and machinery is not solved here, so only these two entries in second and third year. So 31, 3, 14 is the end of second year. Same journal entry, depreciation account debit to machinery account 6250. Again same direction, B, depreciation charged. Again 31, 3, 14. Profit and loss account debit to depreciation account 6250. B, depreciation closed. Again, one more time, write the entry for third year. You have to pass a line, okay? Make a line here. I am making the line. Now write third year. Now copy these two entries again, and the date will change 31, 3, 15. Okay. Depreciation account debit to machinery account 6250. B, depreciation charged. Then 31, 3, 15, profit loss account debit to depreciation account 6250. Being depreciation closed. Okay, so journal entries are over. So till this time, what we have done? We have started with the calculation by writing the accounting years, and important dates are written below. Only one important date is there, because no second machine is there, or machinery is also not sold. If machinery is sold, you have to mention. Then we have calculated annual depreciation, then depreciation is found, and then rate of depreciation. After that, they are asking the entries for journal entries of 3 year. In first year purchase, then depreciation, then close. Sorry, here I made the wrong entry. Profit and loss to depreciation. Okay, first purchase machinery, then calculate depreciation, depreciation to machinery, then close depreciation, profit and loss to depreciation. In second year, depreciation to machinery, profit and loss to depreciation, depreciation to machinery, profit and loss to depreciation. Now we have to prepare this machinery account, and we have to prepare this depreciation account. Two accounts we have to prepare. Okay, so now I am running the whole thing. So this journal entries will be written in your notebook, so you can use that, and we will post the thing. Okay, we know how to do the ledger posting, because we have learned it in the first part, 9th chapter. So now, as you know, after writing the journal entries, we are preparing ledger accounts, and only the accounts which are asked. Ledger. Which ledger is asked? Machinery account. What are the columns? Date, particulars, J, amount, date, particulars, J, amount. Draw this account for minimum 15 lines. How much lines? 15 lines we need. Growth is for 15 lakhs. After that, second account that is asked is depreciation account. Again, same columns, but prepare this account for 6 lines. Not 6 lines, 8 lines you prepare.
Now what you have to do, you have to prepare this both account for 3 years based on the journal entries written. Okay. Now read the first journal entry which I have written. It will be in your notebook because you have to write it. After that only you can prepare this. First entry written was machinery account debit to bank account to cash account. So machinery is debited on debit side of machinery account.
1412. To bank account, to cash account. In bank account, the purchase price 63,600 and in cash account, the expense 1,000.
This was the first entry. Second entry was, and this, see, second effect cannot be given because we are not preparing bank account and cash account, so second effect we cannot give. Now the second entry was depreciation account debit to machinery account. Which entry? Depreciation account debit to machinery account. So depreciation is debited, machinery is credited. So on debit side of depreciation account, 31,330 to machinery account. Amount 6,250. In that entry, depreciation is debited, machinery is credited. So on credit side of machinery account, 31,330 by depreciation account. So this entry will have both effects. This journal entry will have both effects because depreciation account debit to machinery account. So depreciation is debited on debit side of depreciation account to machinery account. Machinery is credited, so on credit side of machinery account by depreciation. Then the last third entry in the first year was profit and loss account debit to machinery account. Now here profit and loss account is not there, but depreciation is credited. Profit and loss account debit to depreciation. Again, I am reading the wrong entry. Profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. So depreciation is credited on credit side of depreciation account, 31,330 by profit and loss account. Amount 6,250. So friends, posting is done for current year, for the first year. Again, we may repeat that machinery account debit to bank account to cash account. So on the debit side of machinery account, to bank and to cash. But bank and cash accounts are not there, so we are not crediting on that side. 63,600 and 1,000. Then second entry was regarding to charge the depreciation. How to charge the depreciation? Depreciation account debit to machinery account. So on debit side of depreciation account to machinery and credit side of machinery by depreciation. Then the third entry was regarding to close the depreciation. So profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. So debit on credit side of depreciation account by P&L account, by profit and loss account. Now first year is over, so you have to close the account for first year. How to close now? See, as we are closing a ledger account, but don't close it below, close it here in the same line, 64,600. So here the balance will be 64,600 minus 6,250, the balance will be 58,350, which shows that after the end of first year, machinery is now only 58,350, and here we will write by balance carried down, means balance sheet. Again, on the next year, leaving one line, next date will be 1,430, because as I have written in the starting, the second year is starting from 1,430. In that, to balance be 58,350. Okay, now what to do again in the here also we have to
6250. So see here,
it is not required to find out the balance because both the sides are equal. This is known as a square dub account. Which account?
Square dub account.
All such things I have explained in first part, chapter number 9. Again, now you have to look the journal entries for second year. In second year, we are not purchasing machine, only two entries. Depreciation account debit to machinery account.
So again on debit side of depreciation account to machinery account. Amount 6250.
And machinery is credited. So on credit side of machinery, 31314
by depreciation account. Amount 6250.
Okay. Now the third entry means second entry of the first year, second entry of the second year, profit and loss account debit to depreciation account.
So again on the credit side by profit and loss account. 6250. So again these accounts are square dub accounts. You can see again both sides are same. And again balance will be found here. Leave one line and make the total 58350. Here also 58350. So our balance will be 58350 minus 6250. It is 52,100. 58350 minus 6250, 52,100. Again on the same day by balance carry down. Then on next year 1414, because after this 31314, third year is from 1414, you will write to balance B. How much? 52,100.
So friends, first year is completed by posting the three entries, that is purchase, then depreciation two effects, and closing the depreciation is P&L account. Then we have closed the account. This account is always squared up. This account is total here and found the balance here. Then balance is taken on the next year. Before taking the balance, you cannot post the journal entries. Again, now in the second year, effect for depreciation, two effects for depreciation and one effect for closing the account. Again, this account is a squared up account. Again, here balance is formed and next is brought here. Now in the third year, entries are depreciation account debit to machinery account. So again, the same thing only we have to repeat by changing the dates. So again, first I am giving the effect here, depreciation account debit to machinery account. So again, we will write here to machinery. 6250. Again here, by depreciation account. Because depreciation is debited on debit side of depreciation to machinery, machinery is credited on credit side of machinery by depreciation, 6250. Again, the second entry is for profit and loss account debit to depreciation account.
Again, on the credit side, 31315 by profit loss account. By profit loss account, 6250. Again, this account is a square dub account. Now, again, we have to find the balance here, 52,100.
52,100 minus 6250 is
45,850. And this is our balance carried down.
Again, on the next year, that is 1415. This date I have not written, but just you have to make a formality to balance brought down 45,850. Yes, now your ledger accounts are over. But the difference of this ledger and chapter numbers 9 ledger is there. That ledgers were only for one time period. These ledgers are for double time period. Double, not triple time period. So, 3-3 accounts effect is there. In short, I am telling that depreciation account is very easy. Because always on debit side, we have to write to machinery. And always on credit side, we have to close by P&L account. So, both sides will be always equal. If I am talking about machinery account, as per the rules of real account, when machinery is coming in, then we have to write on debit side. When depreciation is an expense, so in expense it is debited, here it is credited, and balance is found. Then balance is transferred, again depreciation is there, then balance is found. Again balance is there, again depreciation is done, again there is a balance, and finally take that balance on the fourth year, because 3 years are over, now fourth year, but for fourth year we don't have to make, we have to make till this year. Again, I am reading the question. Now, still one thing is remaining. Write journal entries for first 3 years, that is written. Also prepare machinery account and depreciation account, that is also open. Show accounting effects in annual accounts of first year.
Last thing, effects in annual accounts of first year.
Now when they are asking this question, you have to prepare two more accounts, one liner accounts. First account is profit and loss account as on 31/3/30. Why I am writing as on and why we are not writing here as on? Because these are the annual accounts, means at the end, as I said yesterday also, that when the year ends, we have to see how much expenses are there, how much incomes are there, and how much is our profit and loss. For that we are preparing a profit and loss account, but that account is very big. But comparing to this chapter, how this depreciation will be shown in annual accounts, only that we have to show. So we have to prepare a profit and loss account with particulars amount, only one line.
See, you will prepare it for only one line. And what will you write here that I will show? Particulars and amount. Particular and amount. And what will you show here? I will tell. This is for 31/3/13. So see, second effect of this is only given. What is the actual entry? Profit and loss account debit. So debit side of profit and loss account to depreciation. The whole entry is profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. So here we are writing to depreciation account 6250. Okay, so when the effect is asked in annual accounts, first you have to prepare profit and loss account as on 31/3/13, and second effect only is to be given. Then you have to prepare a balance sheet, which sheet? Balance sheet as on 31/3/13. Okay, now balance sheet is also having two sides, but the two sides are known as assets and liabilities. This is liability side, this is asset side. Now, how you have to show here? Machinery is our asset, so you have to show on asset side. Machinery. In the first year, the total of machinery was 64,600. You have to calculate the depreciation, so minus depreciation. 6250 is in the outer column, 58,350. Means you are just showing what is the status. What is the status of your assets and liabilities? Previously, we have discussed that annual accounts, we are preparing a balance sheet. Balance sheet means what is the status of your liability and what is the status of your asset. In this sum, there is an asset named machinery, which is of 64,600, is cost price. And on 31/3/13, we have found depreciation, we have calculated. So at the end of first year, it is 58,350, same of this, only that thing. Now if they are asking effect in annual accounts of second year, then again prepare profit and loss account, again it will be shown 6250, because second year's depreciation is also 6250. Now how you will show here 58,350 minus 6250, so second year's balance will be 52,100. Again on the same of third year, again here depreciation will be 6250, but again in third year 52,100 minus 6250, your this will show 45,850. Only that is the effect in final accounts. Okay friends, so now we have completed whole sum. We have completed first the calculation, then the calculation of depreciation, then journal entries for 3 years, then ledger accounts, and finally effects in annual accounts. But I am saying that this sum is based sum because it is having all the effects. In exam, all the effects will not be as. Suppose in exam I will ask only calculation and these two accounts. I am not asking journal entry and I am not asking this, because it is of 6 marks, so everything cannot be asked. Or else I will ask only journal entries and only ledger accounts, or else I will ask ledger accounts and only effects in annual accounts.
accounts. Okay, so in exam only that way they can ask. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.